Oh, my dick is going inside my body. My dick is going back inside my body. I can feel my dick going backwards. Fuck.
But at least that guy knows how to speak to a lady.
What, does he?
Hello, beautiful girl. Your husband's fat. Suck my dirty cock.
He has a way with words that you don't understand, Roman. That right there is a gentleman.
Fuck off, cunt. Just get myself ready because I'm about to eat ass. Just don't want to spill any ass down my shirt. Just about to bend like over a couple of people and eat some ass. Oh, but I couldn't possibly. I am stuffed. Okay. I'll have just a little more ass, thank you.
I gotta be honest with you. If my guy had a different haircut and face, I would be so attracted to him.
Hold this for me, please. Okay, he's purposely throwing it. There we go.
Oh, John. I feel different. Oh, John, something ain't right. I feel all cold in the eyes. Is this normal? Have I got the lumbago? Oh, John, is this the tuberculosis? John, I feel different. I can't remember any of my grade school teachers' names. John, something ain't right.
Oh!
Let's go, motherfucker. They're hanging their stockings, he snarled with a sneer. Tomorrow is Christmas, it's practically here. Then he growled with his wrench fingers, nervously drumming. I must find some way to stop Christmas from coming. The Grinch is a motherfucking cunt.
He's made some mistakes, got involved with people he shouldn't have, but really, he's a legitimate businessman.
What about you?
I'm just trying to make the right decisions.
This date is going poorly. I don't know what to do here.
Oh, no! Michelle's been scared off. Michelle! Oh, fuck, shit!
Men, am I right, Benno? That being said, I do want her to empty a fart into my lungs. I just thought of that. I've never said empty a fart into my lungs before. I'm gonna use that all the time now.
POV, it's Valentine's Day. Oh my god.
Problem is, I lost my balls. I'm stuck all over.
We can go jab step.
Ah! Oh my god.
Alright, got
what
me.
What was it? What?
Why is this very offensive to him? After he did you this big favor, you need to be giving him back the money.
I know, but I asked him, I said to him, can I extend that payment, please?
He don't wait for nobody, alright? You give me the money.
God. That really hurt. Alright, I'll try not to go headfirst into walls and shit. That's headfirst into a wall and shit.
This is not what I wanted.
Vertical or horizontal?
Vertical.
I see a deer or something with antlers.
I see a T.
Mission failed.
I see a bird, like a crow or a raven. Sorry, people playing sounds.
I see a horizontal and a circle.
Yep. I see an eye.
I see an attic window.
Oh, hi. Thanks
I
for
see a tree.
I'm still a piece of garbage.
That is not what I'd say. I see a backwards S.
Hey!
No, a normal S.
Someone yeah. Subscribe. I see a love art. Shut up! I see a love art.
Might just go on a rampage. Who likes a piece of my ass? Hello there, Mr. Bearded Fuck. How about a slice of kick? Get the fuck out of here. Girls gone wild every goddamn day. Who likes a piece of this dick? I'm coming for... What the fuck do you want, you... You a homer beard looking motherfucking piece of shit. I'll kill you. I got this.
Get out of my way.
Gotta stomp you. This is like American History X. I'm gonna put your goddamn teeth on the gutter. But this is not racially driven. It's just because you're just in my fucking way. I'm like American History X, but for everybody. Whoop-ya!
Come on. There we go. Unfucking believable. The GMAT stream. The GMAT stream. I gotta fix my camera in the GMAT stream. I gotta light that shit up. Light that shit up. 214 in exposure, just what I want, yeah. Let's deactivate that bitch. And let's activate that bitch. And now it's smooth, 60 FPS. I said it's fucking smooth, it's the motherfucking best, yeah. GMAT stream, it's the GMAT stream. It's the GMAT dream, gonna GMAT cream. Gonna show some memes, gonna make your dreams come true. It's the GMAT stream, bitch.
Hello, how are you? How are you today?
I'm doing really good. Doing really good so far.
Welcome to VHS Store, how are you?
I'm a natural.
Welcome to the store. We have a great selection of horror movies.
I'm doing really well thus far.
Ask this as your emperor and your friend. I have one lesser request.
There's no way you guys heard that. Woo GMAT, yay, right? I think I had everything muted for a second there. What up, y'all? I still don't have the green screen. I keep forgetting to get it in the evening when Sienna's here. And then it comes to the morning to do the stream. And I'm like, I forgot to go and get the fucking green screen I gave her. Hey, you guys, I'm going to bring this over here. You know what? Coffee in the right hand, coffee on the right side. Good morning, how are you doing, everybody? Artsy Fartsy Nerdy Wordy Bronze, how's it going, DJ? Amber, hello, you little scrotum sniffers. Zet, Riggsy, what's going on? Shout out if you're here, home skillets. Keep the chatter going. I am going to jump straight into the game, though, because I need to go at 11:30 to say goodbye to my folks. They're finally leaving Melbourne. So in classic, you know, GMAT family style, where are we going to go for lunch? Ellie! We're going to go somewhere new. We're going to try something different. No, we're going to go to the exact same place we went for a lunch on Thursday or whenever it was they got here last time. Because they're like, oh, we liked that. And I was like, okay. Which I totally understand, but most people are like, why wouldn't you try something different? You're in Melbourne, go somewhere else. I'm like, no, we're going to go to the same cafe we went to the other day. We're going to... The other day when we had... Which day did we catch up for lunch? I don't know if I left a stream for that lunch, but we went to the same Chinese restaurant that we went to last time we were here. Mine and Kirsty's base is better than yours. I highly doubt it because you two bitches are there. You know? My base is elite because of the company. Which is none. If I got to my base and you two were there like, oh, hello, I'd be like, oh, fuck. Creatures of habit. Yeah, they really are, you know. They were smokers for 20 years. they're high-functioning alcoholics. Yeah, when I'm like... I tell them I smoke, and they're like, you've got to be careful, you know? We don't approve of this drugs. I'm like, fucking chill. Why don't I match you bowl for bowl
with drink for drink, and we'll see who dies first. I think you'd actually be quite kind, the real Jimat.
Huh? Huh? Where?
Hello, okay, Luis.
You fucking bitch. You batch.
Delicious. Delicious cold brew. This is the same the cafe that we're going to today is the same cafe I bought those Brazilian beans at the other day that tasted like shit. I wonder if I can return them, even though it's been opened and like had a couple scoops taken out of it. I'll be like, all right, can I bring this coffee back? Because it tasted like shit. I wouldn't have bought this coffee if you put a warning on it that said that it tastes like shit. Oh my God. I've got my YouTube open on my right side. I just looked at all. Look at all that limited monetization. Things that have been like monetizable for a while have been fucking changed. The fuck? Go fuck yourself, YouTube. This is why people are fucking... This is why Rooster Teeth is shutting down, why people are fucking quitting. Such a... Honestly, it's such a... It's so... YouTube are a bunch of pussies now. Just pussies. I have no other word for it. Did you keep the sale hat, by the way? Was that already yours? No. You pay $15 to get the sale hat, which my parents did. And yes, so the answer is yes, I've got the sale hat. My mum grounded me for 6 months for smoking weed when I was 17, then proceeded to smoke with me immediately after. Grounded for 6 months. Yeah, I remember when my brother like smoked weed for the first time. My oldest brother. So I was in primary school still. I would have been like maybe grade 5, grade 6. So like around 10, 11, 12, around that age. And my brother, admittedly, he got caught smoking because he was high at his, like, he worked at a supermarket and he was high at work. And so then, there was this whole kerfuffle. My parents had to go somewhere and they weren't really telling us what was going on. And then they're like, oh, Ellie. They like sat us down. By today's standards, he was doing heroin. That's how seriously they took this conversation. They sat us down and like, your brother has been doing drugs. He's been smoking marijuana. It's been affecting his work, his grades. I thought I was so scared of weed, of marijuana, because of that conversation. They put the fear of God into me. I thought it was like a life-ruining drug. Yes, thank you, DJ. I remember last night I was like, I can't do it. I couldn't do it on my phone. Goodbye. All right. Now, I got to remember what the fuck we were... Which direction we came from? I think we came from that way because we did a cave on the other side of the cliff. And the cave brought us over here. And I think I had to go back to that cave and finish it off because I ended up going in and going into a different path that I didn't need to do. So anyways, yeah, fast forward to now and I'm like, Mum, I smoke a lot of weed. And she's like, oh, no. I'm like, fucking chill, bitch. I'm like, why are you such a fucking loser?
Why are you being so fucking stupid?
What time did you end up for? I went straight to bed after that, DJ. DJ, I don't know why. Thank you for asking me that. People have been, yeah, I'm not sleeping enough. And I feel like some people need to bully me about my sleep because it's getting fucking silly. No, I went straight to bed. I went straight to bed. I put on the my 432 hertz deep sleep REM cycle, like, fucking sounds. I don't like to, I don't know if I've told you guys this. I must have, but I don't like wearing headphones when I sleep. But I've also been like, I've been waking up through the night. And I don't think I'm getting that, I don't think I'm hitting that, my REM cycle. Gotcha, bitch! So there's this like, apparently 432 hertz is like the perfect for calming. It's what people use for meditation. I don't have headphones. I don't like wearing... God, what is wrong with me? Why can't I piece a fucking sentence together? I don't like wearing headphones when I sleep. So I installed these speakers above my bed so I get the left and right, because apparently it only really works if you get left and right. And now every single night, if you walked past my bedroom in the middle of the night, you would hear quite fucking loudly... And it is quite loud. It's a little absurd. You would hear this. Oh, it's probably going to come through.
You're listening to the 8-Hour Sleep Music Podcast.
Just picture, this is me asleep. Just sleep apnea. I'm just not. This. I stopped breathing for like 6 minutes. That's me. I've been using the Empty Bowl podcast. It's about cereal. I listen to music between 5 and 9 hertz. It's way more, like, obviously I'm asleep by that point, but it does help me get to sleep and I don't wake up through the night. It's like a white noise machine almost, but like when I started listening to it, it's a lot more gentle. It's not the one I listened to, surely. What was the one I listened to last night?
You're listening to the 8-Hour.
It's just like tranquil, low hums and shit like that. anyways, so that's been playing very loudly in my bedroom. And it's kind of been helping me sleep. It's helping me get to sleep, and I'm not waking up throughout the night, which is ideal. I think my teeth grinding so bad, it sounds like someone walking through the thick snow. Oy, oy, oy. I don't wake up during the night. Yes, stopping breathing will do that to you. The snow is fucking me up. I keep losing what direction I'm running. I'm so sorry, Zet. And there was no warning either. I just sort of started the stream. About 4 hours into the track, it changing to kill everyone. I'm about 4 hours into the track, it changing to kill everyone. Repeated over. Whoa, Munty, what the fuck does that even mean? About 4 hours into the track, it changing to kill everyone, in quotes. Oh, about 4 hours into the track, it changes to kill everyone. Repeated over. I see the joke you're going for. That's a very funny joke. It was written very, very poorly. And you know what? I'm going to shame you for it. Shame. Dork. I heard a study done that people sleep better with someone next to them. He's up, cunt. I did a study that was done with every woman I've ever slept next to, and I guarantee they disagree. Whoever did that study has clearly never had a woman fucking pull the fucking blanket away, and you fuck, give it up. Fuck. I don't know what it is with women. They're like, they're hoarders. Every woman I've ever slept next to is just like, did you want some blanket? Fuck you, fatso. I'm like, whoa. Why the derogatory language? And they're like, eat shit, and they take the entire blanket. Obviously, they don't say fuck you, fatso, but they want to. They want to. My God, Sam, I always wake up. That's why, like, I got... Beck and I had two doonas. Because I was like, this is absurd. I keep waking up fucking freezing. And the first night we slept in the bed with the two doonas, she took the second doona. So she had two doonas and I had zero. And then, you know, if I drink, I snore. It's just a well-known fact of mine. Fuck off, fuck off, fuck off! What are you doing, you dog? Oh, I'm fucking on fire, that's why. You are a cunt. There's nothing I can do. I can't roll. Yeah, if I drink, I snore. So on the rare occasion that I'm drunk and snoring, I remember her being like, you snored very loud last night. I'm like, let's not get into a battle of fucking sleeping, all right? Now, I don't know which is the cave for me. Have I been in this cave? I should have put markers down. I must have been in this cave because I've got a little house over there. I snore super bad. I've heard your snoring, Cumberwaffle. after the... Yeah, yeah. Here's the thing. Here's the thing, Cotton Waffle. 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 I've heard... maybe one... God, I'm so sorry. I've heard maybe one other person in my life who snored as terribly as you did that night. And it was like, it was my dying grandfather. I thought you were dying. It was like a death rattle. Something about booze, man. Especially beer. Beer as well is a killer for me. Once they get all bloated and full of booze, it's just like... Yeah, it's fucking... It's Goodnight Moon. I bought an EV to sleep in that. I bought an EV to sleep in that if we do have a... What's an EV? I will never live it down. You really won't. It's the gift that keeps on giving. An electric car. Gotcha. I feel like everybody has like one thing they'll never live down. And for us, it's always something we did around musical theater people. I was actually in the bunk right below Comma Waffle. And it was, it shook the... No, it didn't. I'll ease up. Sienna said she was contemplating smothering me. Oh, that's so funny. Now, I believe... Oh, unless it's that one over there. I was going to say, I thought this was the cave, but it could be that cave over there. No, that was the cave I left. So you guys don't care about any of this. I think this is the cave. Unless it's that bitch up in the mountains.
Yeah.
I have to go in fucking an hour. Let's just do this cave. This is the cave because there's my fucking wheelie. Sorry the streams have been cutting short so much, gang. My parents are going back to Shepparton today, so I won't have to do any hanging out with my folks things. Oh, the glider. Yes, thank you, Dirty. That's fucking... Thank you. I was just genuinely going to walk away from it then. I'm not used to being able to put it in my backpack.
Just gotta send a message.
Oi, this big is boy. My theme song. We just made I'm some Italian. Money. High five, bitch. Fuck you. You're fat.
You're fat. Ah. All right. How do we real quickly? I need to create a little base. You know what? I'll just do it on this one. I played Kaiju. It's just if I switch to the other PC, my mouse will get stuck in the middle of the screen, which means I have to reset the game. And if I reset the game, I'll go back to my last save point. Pizza, pasta with SMG Mario, the very original version. Video. Pizza, pasta, put it in the box, bring it here and put it on my top, the tortellini on my weenie, pepperoni on the walls, cheesy on my beanie, and some salsa on my balls. I want that to be my fucking text tone. No, this is what I want to be my text tone. Motherfucking hyped up. Right. The nigga just grabbed the nigga, snuffed the nigga, and it was on from there. The motherfucker, it wasn't nothing stopping him.
What the rest of his niggas do?
Man, the motherfuckers was ready for anything. The niggas was packing burners. The niggas was ready to fight, whatever they had to do, homes. The niggas was on the real flip mode, homes. They was chilling out like a motherfucker. Right. The nigga was amped. He was like, come on! Come on, motherfucker!
Come on, motherfuckers, come on! Come on, motherfuckers, come on! Yeah. Come on, motherfuckers, come on! Come on, motherfuckers, come on!
Release the brainstorm to make your motherfucking brain warm. A strange form, something kind of lyrical.
Enough of that. Kaiju, thank you so much for the big donation. 50 bones. That's very useful right now. Unbelievably useful. That's hard as fuck.
That shit go hard.
Sienna was playing this one the other day, which... is fucking huge. This one goes out to my boy Kaiju.
She take my money when I'm in need. Yeah, she's a trifling friend indeed.
Oh, did it go, nigga?
Way over town. That digs on me.
She give me money. Now I ain't saying she a gold digger, but she ain't messing with no broke niggas. Now I ain't saying she a gold digger, but she ain't messing with no broke niggas. Get down, girl, gon' head, get down. Get down, girl, gon' head, get down. Get down, girl, gon' head, get down. Get down, girl, gon' head. Judy the bomb, met her at a booty salon with a baby who was for time. Under her underarm, she said, I can tell you rock, I can tell by your charm. Boss girls, you gotta fly, I can tell by your charm and your arm. But I'm looking for the one, have you seen her? My psychic told me she have an ass like Serena, Trina, Gina for Lopez. Four kids, and I gotta take all they badass to show this. Okay, get your kids, but then they got their friends. I put up in the bins, they all got a bin. We all went to den, and then I had to pay. If you fucking with this girl, then you better be paid. You know why? Take too much to touch her. From what I heard, she got a baby by Buster. My best friend said she used to fuck with Usher. I don't care what none of y'all say, I still love her.
Hala tu cuerpo, alegría, Macarena. Que tu cuerpo es pa' dar alegría, cosa buena. Hala tu cuerpo, alegría, Macarena. Macarena. Hala tu cuerpo, alegría, Macarena.
Fucking phenomenal. Anyways, back to what we were doing.
She gave me money. Well, I'm in need.
Seamless transition. Kaiju. Oh, fuck, what's that noise? Kaiju, appreciate you very much, pal. $50 is no small amount of money, and I promise you it helps out a lot. Don't die. Oh, I won't die.
She give me money!
Keep on being awesome. Can't promise that, but I'll keep making fart noises. I'll keep doing the fart jokes. Now, we don't really need to check every corner of this cave because technically we've been here before. I just need to get to the end of the cave. The other thing is that nothing has come up yet that has guaranteed me that I've been in this cave. I would have liked to have seen something I recognized. But my wheelie was outside. I feel like I remember skipping these cunts. That guy's going to hit way harder than the others.
cutie the bomb. Met her at a beauty salon with a baby Louis Vuitton under her underarm. I said, I could tell you right. I could tell by your charm. He gave me money. When I go underwater, I talk like an Animal Crossing character. It's a condition. It's more like an affliction. I need warmer clothes. This bitch cold.
Yeah.
Call the tism. I got a touch of the tism. Hi Oko, how are you? I feel like I haven't seen you in a while. What have you been up to? How's work going? You keeping that thing clean for daddy? Keeping that bitch clean. Fuck. Using that fucking, you using that Manscaped ball perfume? You keeping that thing clean for daddy? Yeah. Nobody ever used that. I don't know if I told you guys this because Manscaped was a sponsor at the time, but I remember using the fucking the ball deodorant, and it's like a cologne. And I put it on, and I was like, "That's uncomfortable." And then also, it like burnt the fuck out of my urethra, and it hurt to piss for like 4 days. That shit's a nightmare. You shouldn't be putting anything, any chemicals, any smelly shit near your balls and penis. Just wash your cock and balls like a fucking adult. You don't need to put cologne on your fucking cock. I shout, say yes, the bitch is clean. The bitch is... Oh, you're the bitch. Gotcha. I would never refer to you that way, K-Lewis. I would never use such derogatory gendered language to address you. You whorish slut. I would never in my days... Wait, what did I just say? Burning's never a good sign. It's no fucking good. My razor died. The USB charger just either just stopped working or the thing just stopped taking charge. The cologne burnt my nutsack. The shirt has become like, the underpants, and we said this like even when they were our sponsors, the underpants are horse shit. The underpants are some of the worst underpants I've ever put on my body. And the shirt, Ben still uses his shirt, his is good, but mine is just like the bottom of it's just so loose, just blowing in the wind. I hate it. I think Manscaped is one of the shittest companies. I think their marketing is elite. And what they offered, it was like there was a hole in the market and they filled it. Which isn't that like rule one of capitalism? Like when people are trying, like on Tropper. Oh, I can never say that word, so I'm not going to bother. That rule is like find a hole in the market and fill it. If you're just trying to, you know, build revenue and it's not about chasing a passion. All right, let's see where this bitch goes. Jesus.
Capitalism filling holes. Capitalism in the free market filling holes. It's like I know it, artsy fartsy, but when I say entrepreneur. You know, there was a point I had a teacher once. Let me work out how to say the word.
Bonjour, this is how you pronounce this word. Originally a word that designates a person who sets up a business. In French, this is normally said entrepreneur. Entrepreneur, but in English or American, it is usually pronounced as entrepreneur.
Entrepreneur. Entrepreneur. See, even when I say it, it still sounds wrong. Anyways, I had a teacher at uni, you know, when I did my honors year, and it was a very small class. It was like five of us. She said, and this is well before GMAT stuff, she said, I think you have an entrepreneur's spirit. And I think you're going to go very far. Like, she was just gassing me up. She can go very far because you have an entrepreneur spirit. Blah, 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 blah. And I wanted to quote what she said because that's, like, stuck with me. And I wanted to tell someone. I can't remember who I was telling. And I couldn't pronounce the word, so I just threw in the towel. I didn't tell the story. Yeah. That accent gets you in trouble, that one. Entrepreneur. Entrepreneurship. So you don't say the... Because it's... There's an R after the P. It's like entrepreneur. You're saying it's entrepreneur. You're saying get rid of the entrepreneur. Entrepreneur's way easier to say entrepreneur. But that French guy said entrepreneur. Holy fuck balls. Entrepreneur. This is the way I came. I remember this. Entrepreneur. Yes, but he's French. Let's not fault him for that. American way. Entrepreneur. 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 It's crazy that, like, Aiden and I hated this teacher. She was one of those, like, no bullshit fucking... But the no bullshit thing often manifested in just being nasty for the sake of it. Like, she didn't actually... Sometimes it was like, you're missing the mark here, lady, and you think you're right, but you're just being, like, awful. I think your desire to be a tough, no bullshit teacher has masked your, is getting in the way of the truth. I remember in our first year, Aiden and I were doing an improv class and she took over the improv class. And my improv teacher, I don't know if you've seen, my improv teacher was the nicest fucking guy. He was just a sweet, sweet man. Where is he? Oh my God, he looks so young there. I was trying to see if it's in a commercial because there's some commercial he's in that everyone fucking knows in Australia. This is him.
William Gibson once said, if he had have existed, he certainly would have racked up his frequent flyer miles. Welcome to the show.
What is happening?
Oh, you're talking through time.
What?
Are you
I'm seriously freaking out right now.
That's okay. I'm a freaky guy. You're one of the greatest explorers history has ever known.
Well, you flatter me.
What's your favorite place that you visited and why?
Well, I love this little restaurant down the street called Maroma's. They do a wonderful pizza.
Oh, yeah. Oh, and why is the pizza wonderful?
Well, it's an unusual shape.
It's an unusual ship.
Ship?
It's a ship.
Ship?
It's like a boat made of pizza.
No, a ship.
Oh, a shape.
Like a circle or a square or a triangle. But this is a polyolagon.
An olagon?
A polyolagon.
A polyolagon.
You'll never tasted pizza until you've had a polyolagon in pizza.
Well, how does it affect the flavor?
I'm sorry, who are you?
I'm Ziggy Montgomery.
Pleased to meet you, Ziggy.
Oh, nice to meet you too.
I'm a generic Eastern European.
Now, on your journeys throughout the world, you...
He's an absurd man. Anyways, he was fun. We had him for improv. And then this bitch showed up. And in the first class... Well, that was it at Combo Waffle. Aiden didn't cope. He got into fights constantly. He's been in shit, DJ. You would have seen his face in something. He was one of the background actors for Thank God You're Here and stuff like that. So this teacher, she shows up. After the first class, she separates. She goes, all right, boys go to that side of the room, girls go to that side of the room. And we're like, okay, that's weird. And we did that. And she's like, boys, you're doing fine. I was like, okay. And she was like, girls, literally all of you are terrible. And there's just no way that was true. Because a lot of the boys sucked. And there were good girls. So it was some sort of like... It was some sort of power move or something she was trying to pull to like get inside everyone's heads. That's when I first realized, oh, this person may just be being mean as a like a teaching technique. But that was like instantly, I'm like, you missed the mark. You fully missed the mark because a lot of the girls are doing great and it's weird that you just separated us by gender so that you could generically say everyone of that gender is terrible and everyone of this gender is doing great. That's the big Greek salami. So eventually, by the end, you know, fast forward 4 years, Riggsy, and she might have been one of my favorite people on campus. Because we started to, you know, we built a rapport and we started being able to call her out on her bullshit. You know, she was also like, she was gay and that's, you know, that helped her and Aiden bond a little bit because she, you know, she had some experiences as a gay woman. Like, you know, by that point she was in her 40s and, you know, her family had completely disowned her when she was like 15. You know, so she'd had some experiences and... I mean, it's natural. She felt like she was able to connect more with Aiden because she's like, all right, we have a shared experience of like what it's like to not be heterosexual and... Oh, fuck. How the fuck did I... How do I get out of here? I want to go back the way I came. This is the same problem I had before. Fuck. Fuck. I just keep running out of fucking breath. Let's get some energy. Oh, rope. That's right. It's all coming back to me. It's all coming up, G-Man. Everything's coming up, Mo. Oh, no. That thing is quite large. Now, we go this away. New York's that away, man. Maybe they had a big slide. Yeah, but it was after the big slide I was trying to work out where to go. How long left, boy, you have to go? 35 minutes. Oh, that's right. Mate, I got a message from... Go this way? Where am I going? Hello? May I drink your drink? I guess not. Ziggy play guitar. Jabbing good with Weird and Gilly. And the spiders from Mars. Yeah, he played it 11. But made it too far. Get the special man. Maybe this cave was done. Maybe I did everything I could in this cave. Him, the spiders from Mars. He played it 11, but made it too far. Maybe this cave was just meant to lead me into the other cave. Little extra caving. Right now I want to cave my own fucking head in. Fuck me, I guess. Try this direction. My direction selection. Fuck off, cunt. You've been knocked out, bruv. Because you're about to be. I kick you in the fucking head. I did get a recording of me singing that song last night for this concert with the band. But the recording's so shit, you can barely hear anything. What's in the case for you to get any? Well, like supplies and shit like that. But at the moment, fucking nothing, apparently. The problem with this cave, Artsy Fartsy, is that the island has a mountain in the center of it. So you basically, you can go around the island, but you can't really cut through it. I think you can cut through it, but it's quite hard. So on the opposite side of the island where I am now, I've gone into a cave, and that cave, after a lot of exploring, led me through tunnels, and it ended up lining up with another cave on the other side of the island. So this cave went straight through. And the reason I came back to go into the cave again was just to make sure I didn't miss anything. Because after I slid down that thing, there's no going back. And sliding down that thing is what led me to where I am now. Tell the person you're acting opposite that she's the best. Amy? Do you know Amy? Come over. Now it is work. That one, the one that plays your wife, try not to dox. That plays your wife. I don't know what you're talking about, Cumwaffle. I was talking about, I'm doing a concert. It's like a 10-year anniversary concert for this theater company called Western Arts. And I'm singing a song from Shrek. And that's what I got the recording from last night with the band. But I told everyone, I'd be like, I'll get a recording because I had that rehearsal. Are we talking about different things? Are you talking about School of Rock? Yes, yeah. Sorry, we're talking about two different things. Yes, Connie. We can dox Connie. Me and Connie went and saw Groundhog Day the other day, and she was loud. She laughed so friggin' much. It was a very, very fucking funny show. Also, she came over the other night and we were like, let's get high. Let's watch Tenacious D. And we got high and we didn't watch anything. We just sat on the couch individually looking at reels on Instagram. And just like laughing to ourselves. We were stoned. Fuck. fuck off, Norton.
Talking away. I don't know. Up the theater.
Mat reused. Not gonna lie, I'm frazzled at the moment. I thought that was my ad blocker and tried to get rid of it. Oh, I'm so sorry. I know, someone made fun of me the other day for having antivirus. Someone said like antivirus is like a scam. But it was something my old man used to have. And my old man knows nothing about computers. So I just have antivirus and always have. And I've never looked into it to be like, do I need antivirus? I will come waffle next time we're hanging out. Do you have dogs come waffle? Because there's a dog park in... I don't want to say where it is because I don't want to dox either of our locations, but it's kind of like halfway between me and Connie. And I tell you, it's a fenced in off lead dog park. And we'll hit you up because she just comes down to play with dogs sometimes. I'm just, every time I go down to take Ellie for a walk, I just send her a message. I'm going down. If you're free, come down. I do, but he's a cunt. How much of a cunt? Because Ellie could be a little cunt sometimes, but this dog park's fenced in and she's good with other dogs, so she just runs around, gets her energy out. I don't know. Not sure if he'd get on with Ellie. Not everyone gets on with Ellie. But she's also good at, like, if she gets bullied, she just, like, backs off. She doesn't engage. Yeah, she'd give a good gauge. Talk it away, motherfucker city. I don't know what I'm to say. This better fucking get me the bitch out of here. Today's another day to find you. I'll chat to you later about that and I'll send you the 12. Oh, yes, please. Shying away. Fuck. That thing took 2 bars off my armor. I don't even know what the hell that was. How do you know the hell they were? So you weren't here when we played Beauty and the Beast, Comma Waffle. I think that was one of the first ones we played on stream that people wanted to see. No, Seussical. We started with Seussical. But I think people like really enjoyed Beauty and the Beast. Like the end of that one, they're like, that was fun. At least Amber and Kay, I remember, like, that was fun. I love Beauty and the Beast. I missed this morning. I was Sunday and I was having a nappy. Hey, you got to do what you got to do, Zen. I don't think your belt was pitchy at all. Come waffle. What I've come to learn is that even when you feel like you're pitchy, like you're like, oh, that note wasn't quite there, even people who are like, even people with good ears mostly just don't give a fuck. They sort of take it in context with the rest of the song. The only person who ever analyzes it deeply is the person who's singing the note. To the point, like, I've had some, like, I've been like, there was a recording from Seuss and I was like, oh, I missed that. And they're like, what? And they go back and listen and they're like, oh, you did. You were a little pitchy on that note. But, like, that's them going, oh, when I watched it myself, it was in context, I just didn't really hit my ears. You can get away with a fucking lot. That was a bat flying underwater. Part of the imposter syndrome, to be honest. Yeah. Fuck. I feel like I did that last time. It's that way when you're like in a solid cast and you look around, and you're like, am I the weak link? I never do that because I have a massive ego. My advice, get a giant ego. I don't know what's the best way to get back to my base, but I'm going to go with this. I go around the mutton. Got one. Now what? Ride it, baby. Let that shit sing. Fucking get me back to base. Fucking honestly. It sucks, CC. Fighting off those guys while also trying to fight off Wolf. It's just everything coming at you at once. Just never get close to Wolf. Just pick Wolf off from a distance. That's what I always do. Take care of the guys around you. Get out a sniper or a rocket or something with, like, what's the, like, night vision or whatever vision, thermal vision. Yeah. So I'm going to get back to camp and then we're going to have like 15 minutes to do nothing. Who wants to watch me and Combo Waffle sing a song together? All we did in this stream was answer the question. Was there anything left in that cave? No. Okay. And that was the whole stream. I also can't see a fucking thing. But I know the base is coming up soon. The base is around here somewhere. There it is. Fuck! How do you not die when you fly in that hot? No, I can't see dubstep. All right. Oh, winter's over. Yes. That's going to be good for the next stream. All right. Let's have a look at this song. Uh-oh. My shit's fucked up. So we already played this. We played this a long time ago. We played the oh. Oh, sorry. My shit's been fucky. We played the entirety of the show. This is a song from Act 2. If you know Beauty and the Beast, Gaston and LeFou, played by myself and my buddy Greg, go to visit Monsieur Dark or Monsieur d'Arc to set up a plan to put Belle's dad into the insane asylum that this guy runs. And that's this song. I think that happens in the original cartoon, right? There's just no song. Let's have a looky-loo. Oh, wait, do I have it? Surely I've got Beauty and the Beast. Shows. Seuss. If I were... maybe it's on my other Beauty and the Beast. Videos. This it? La la la. Oh, I think this is it.
Oh, oh, there's something on me. Ah, ah, it's a spider. It's a spider. It's a thread. It's a thread.
Let's get rid of me.
Careful of the fourth wall.
Him. Ah, thank you for coming on such short notice, Monsieur Dark.
Monsieur Dark, and I don't usually leave the asylum in the middle of the night, but this fellow said you'd make it worth my while.
Ouch, ouch. It's like this, see, I've got my heart set on marrying Belle, but she needs a little persuasion.
Turn him down flat.
It's like this, see. There's a danger I'll be thwarted and denied my honeymoon. For the pretty thing I've courted refuses to swoon. So the time has come for a murky plan, for which I turn to a murky man.
To find that fiend,
we're better than the Maison de Lune. I don't take this girl for granted. There's no path I haven't hewn. To her heart, no seed unplanted, no flower unstrewn. But quite amazing to relate, she doesn't want me for her mate.
Which forces him to contemplate
the Maison de Lune.
I don't wish to seem a tad obtuse,
but I don't see how I can be of use. For I lock people up, I'm not a lonely hearts club. I'm a cold, cold fish, I'm a nasty, vicious streak.
Oh, please speak, that's so scary.
It's Belle's father who's your client. She adores the old buffoon. She'll be forced to be compliant. She'll dance to your tune. We'll get the daughter through her dad. You just pronounce the old boy mad.
And what she slammed up in your pad.
The Maison de... Do I make myself entirely clear? It's the simplest deal of my whole foul career. Put Maurice away and she'll be here in moments.
In a dreadful state.
She'll capitulate to me.
Oh, I'll be strapping up an inmate.
Very tightly.
Hey, but please don't bring him in late. I'll check in time's noon.
So wave one bachelor goodbye. She'll be my bride.
She'd rather die than have her daddy
ossify in my sordid saloon.
So put the church raised glasses high to the Maison de
Lot of spooky boys. I love doing that song, Come Waffle. That might have been my favorite moment in the show. Or Gaston. I did like Gaston. But that was lots of fun. What I remember enjoying about that show was like, you know when you do a show and you fucking... There's parts and you're like, ugh, I've got to do this bit. Like, I don't know, Seussical. What was fucking shit in Seussical? Oh, I did. I always hated the circus. The circus. Circus McGurkus. The fucking...
Tell yourself how lucky you are. That little
fucking bit. I hated doing that every time I did it. There wasn't any bits like that in Beauty and the Beast. Every time I came out, I was like, yeah, I like this bit. I like doing this bit. I like doing this bit. This is fun. This is good. Yeah. It's fucking, yeah. Good shit. All right, gang. I better hit the road so I don't, so I'm not late for lunch with my folks.
Daddy gonna get some free lunch. Daddy gonna get some free lunch.
All right. I'll catch you guys. I'll see you guys tomorrow night.